I am founder and the CEO of Gelastic. So Gelastic, it's a platform as a service and infrastructure as a service in one package. So it's like Heroku, it's like Kubernetes and other kind of platform as a services. But the difference, it was designed for hosting service providers in different countries, so they can provide services in different countries. Plus, we have advantages and technical features. So today we will talk about very unique feature in containers, like live migration. So it's very like high level technology today. Not everyone can afford such kind of technology. And I would like to share how do we use this technology with our solution. So to think about live migration, a good analogy, I like analogies. So to think from an analogy point of view, so live migration, it's like teleportation. It's like the time gate. So you can, come to one gate and out from another one. So and you travel across the time and the distance. Of course, today we don't have gates, time gates and teleports. Sorry, but. If we have a technology, I believe in the future we will be able to build the portals for humans as well. So today we have portals for containers. And I would like to share some knowledge which we collected during the work with containers. So, but about the problem, can we do a little bit, can we adjust a little bit the screen?
I don't think so.
Okay, I see. So, unfortunately, so I will read.
I have no idea on how to do that. So.
Okay, I see. So, what is the problem actually? What kind of problems we have actually? Sysadmin guys that manage data center. It's hardware maintenance. When you do a hardware maintenance, you have to shut down like, hardware. And together with hardware, you shut down applications which are hosted on top of this hardware. And this is an issue because nobody wants to get in downtime. So another one issue, unbalanced cluster load. Sometimes you have very high load on one physical machine and very low load on another one. And to reload this, to rebalance the load, again, you need to redirect some traffic from one hardware node to another one, or migrate somehow applications, and it's not an easy task actually to do. So sometimes again, downtimes happen during load rebalance. So another issue that we have: not every cloud is a good cloud. And to migrate your application from one cloud to another cloud, you need to spend enough efforts to rebuild everything and to recreate environments, reconfigure it, and so on. So this problem can be solved in different ways. How people solve it today? There are several solutions for that. Planned downtimes. When you do maintenance of hardware, you notify end users so at that date we will have downtime, so please be ready for that. It's not the best approach, but it's a reality. So another way to handle to solve the issue is traffic rerouting. For example, you create another version of your application and you reroute the traffic, you reroute the load from one hardware node to another hardware node. But it's not easy to do because your application should be designed for such kind of traffic rerouting. There is a synchronization issue. So not every application will be ready for traffic distribution, for traffic rerouting, sorry. And new one, like microservices, it's a very great solution. It's a hype today, so almost at every conference we talk about microservices. And so microservices expect, sorry, what happened? Yeah. So when you write microservices, so your application should expect downtimes of specific parts of your application and without performance degradation. So you design your application in a specific way. So the application, if one container is down, the application continues to work. But the issue here, again, it's not easy because you need to know like how to design it. And it does not work for legacy applications because nobody wants to rewrite legacy applications. So it's not easy task. And the last one that we believe simplifies significantly all efforts for migration, for cluster rebalance, for cluster maintenance, is a live migration. When you can migrate applications without any interruption, without any downtime from one hardware node to another one. So and how it works? Let's say we have a virtual machine. For some reason it doesn't show images. I mean it's animation. Okay. No, it's animation. Sorry guys, my laptop is not adjusted for this kind of projector. Okay, so how it works, I will draw on the screen. We have one virtual machine and we have containers inside. And let's imagine we have new one, virtual machine, and what you do, you migrate these containers without downtime from this virtual machine to another one. And after that, you just shut down this one. So pretty straightforward. And you don't need to redesign your applications for that because it's done on bottom level, on the infrastructure level. So how it works? How live migration works? It's pretty complex like solution. It's pretty complex task. I will try to explain in simple words. Let's say we have source node and destination node. And you want to migrate in a container from source node to destination node. So what we do, we freeze container at some point, and after that we get a state of container, so memory state. And we transfer this state to destination node, we restore everything and unfreeze. So it sounds pretty simple, but in reality it's very hard to do because many things happens during the migration, so and you need to know how to handle the things. There is a issue during migration. There is a little time frame when application will be frozen. So during this time, application is not able to handle requests. The duration of this time depends on the specific application, on a specific application. So if your application writes very intensive bytes to memory, time frame will be longer. So if your application is not very busy, it will be shorter. But anyway, like it's much better to have, let's say, like 10-20 seconds freeze than complete downtime. And like when you reboot the node, it takes much more time, actually. There are two kinds of live migrations, solutions for live migrations, containers. One of them is pre-copy memory. So how it works? Again, we have like source node. We turn track on memory changes. And we copy the less busy pages of memory to another source node. And we copy like file system, so we copy data which is not changing during the time. So after that, and actually this process is iterational. So you do this several times until you have very little data inside RAM. After that, you again like you freeze, get this little data, get the state, migrate to source node, restore, and unfreeze and clean up the previous one. So this is the magic how it works. And the frozen time is between two points, like freeze and unfreeze. So another option for migration is post-copy memory. Or in other words, it's like lazy migration. How it works? We have source node, we get the state, but in this case, we get the most active pages of RAM. And we migrate these pages to destination node. So, and all requests are coming now to destination nodes. And after that, we move the rest of the data to destination node. So, for some cases, one option is better, for another case, another option is better. Today we use pre-copy memory, because post-copy is pretty new solution, and it was recently implemented. So, how live migration can help in DevOps direction? I believe everyone heard about Docker containers, right? And how many people are using Docker containers today? Okay, great. How many people are using in production? Okay, sounds good. So Docker is amazing technology. Docker introduced container technology. Actually, container technology is not a new technology, but Docker introduced it, this technology for developers and for sysadmin guys. In the past, it was mostly used by like infrastructure service providers, like hosters. Technology is about 15 years on the market already. But Docker allows to use this technology for continuous integration and continuous delivery. And what is the standard workflow for continuous delivery with Docker containers? We have Hub Registry. Hub Registry is the place where we store containers, right? And for example, you want to deploy new application. So what you do? You pull the image from Hub Registry. Let's say it's a Tomcat or it's like Nginx. You provision this container inside your laptop, and it's live now. And after that, you make some changes and you commit back to Hub Registry. So after that, what you do, you call test guys, or it's automated in different departments. It's different, and they pull this image on test environment. They test it, and if everything is okay, after that, image is pulled by ops guys, sysadmin guys, and they pull it to stage environment, and they do some internal tests, and if everything is okay, again, admin guys move it to production, to one production and another one production. So this is the standard flow with containers. Very easy now, it's much easier now, because it's more standard way, you know, you deliver almost the same, not almost, the same image from Hub Registry to different destinations, to different stages. So how we can improve this solution with live migration? There is another option when you connect Hub Registry only to your dev environment, and you pull the image. At the beginning, the process is almost the same. And when everything is good, you commit it back. But after that, you can just migrate the whole application from this environment to another one. You can do live migration or you can do offline migration. So after that, test guys can test it, and if everything is okay, you just migrate to another stage. And after that, you can clone it and migrate to one production and another one production. So in this case, you don't need to repack and rebuild your containers every time. It's not widely used yet because live migration is not available by default for Docker containers, but Docker team is working on live migration as well. So they did a demo the last year in Barcelona. They showed like migration of Minecraft server from one physical node to another one. So again, like it's an optional. If you like it, if it fits to your like process inside your organization, you can use it. So if you don't like it, so you can use another option. So what kind of use cases we have with live migration? So as I mentioned, the first one, the most obvious inside one data center, when you do a maintenance of a physical hardware, you can migrate your applications from one physical hardware node to another one. This is one of the most obvious. So another one, across multiple data centers of the same vendor. It can be used by infrastructure service providers, and it can be used by end customers. Why? For example, by service providers, they can migrate workloads from one data center to another one. And the same for end customers. For example, you want to migrate close to your customers, like, and you can migrate easily with this live migration to another data center. And you don't change anything, IP addresses, domains, like anything, because these data centers are in the same network, in the most cases. And the next one is the most difficult, actually, and this is very new on the market. It's live migration across multiple data centers of different vendors. So what it means? It means, for example, you host your application on Azure or on Amazon. And Azure gives you nice bonuses, like for free, for a year. Of course, you would love to benefit from these bonuses, but migration is not an easy task. So with help of live migration, you can easily migrate your applications without downtime from one cloud to another one. So it reduces significantly the amount of efforts you spend on it. And another use case, let's say, like you don't like your service provider anymore, like local service provider or like service providers from another country, like because often downtimes are like too expensive, and you have an option to migrate it easily without any involvement of service provider. You just press button and application migrates from one data center to another. It gives us freedom to choose service providers. It gives it forces service providers to provide good quality of services. I believe many of you are using Google Maps when you drive on the streets. And sometimes Google tells you, hey, my friend, I found like faster road, like you can save 15 minutes, right? So the same should be with cloud platform. So your platform should tell you, hey, my boss, I found a better service provider for you. It's cheaper, faster, like, and it's close to your customers. Would you like to migrate during the night, just press this button. And you press button and all workloads will be moved to another service provider. It's a dream, actually. It's not possible yet today, so we are working on it. Because there are some hidden issues, so we need to solve before we get to the stage. But I believe we are very close to this point. What kind of, actually multi-cloud benefits, I explained this. So it's autonomy, so no vendor locking. You are not locked into anyone. If you have live migration, you just migrate by one click and don't spend efforts. Hybridity, you can choose different kind of hardware vendors, like, let's say like for development, some cheap, low performance, for production, more high performance, better quality. And the availability and disaster recovery across different data centers. So live migration or just migration, like offline migration, helps significantly to achieve these goals. Again, it was like, an animation, like demo how it migrates from Azure to Amazon. We have this demo, it's live, it works today. And you can migrate pretty any kind of application from Azure to Amazon. It requires some specific configuration of Azure and Amazon. But if you do it, you do it once, and after that, you can benefit from this live migration across the clouds. Again, multi-cloud DevOps pipeline. So as I showed before, you can migrate from one region to another one, and after that to another cloud, and in that cloud to another region. So without any interruption of application. So you don't need to rebuild every time your containers at that point, because maybe you don't want to connect this cloud to your hub registry. So why do you need to do that? So, or maybe you have very like strict policy rules inside your company. So what kind of bottlenecks and hiding issues we have with flight migration? Oops. So first of all, it's a performance degradation. During the light migration, unfortunately, there is some performance degradation. Because first of all, we copy data, so some I/O load increases. And of course, this time freeze. So if your application is is very sensitive to this freeze, and it's not a good solution for you. But if it's a simple like web application and you don't have a huge traffic on one container, it's absolutely okay. Because even you can have multiply containers like microservices, and you can migrate microservices as well without downtime. Or just clustered environment. So one container will be freezed, all other containers will work in normal way. Big data and fast changing data. Very hard to migrate data containers that change in state inside very fast, because this delta will be, it's very hard to get small delta. And big data, again, it's not easy to migrate big data, so sometimes it's better to get a rack and move to another data center. So. Why I tell you? Because if you know what is the best way to use live migration, what kind of bottlenecks you have, you can plan your design your architecture in the right way. And another one, public IP addresses in multi cloud. So if you migrate from one cloud to another one, you cannot use the same public IP address. If you use the same vendor, the most likely vendor has the same network across different data centers, so you can transfer IP address. But across clouds, from Amazon to Azure, it's impossible. You need to build load balancing for that across these clouds. And it's possible to do again. Market offering today. So who provides live migration containers, actually who created them. There are two layers for containers live migration. First of all, containers engine. There is a team like Creo. It's sub-project from OpenVZ. So these guys created live migration. We are using their knowledge and their technology. And this technology was open sourced and is open sourced and was committed to Linux kernel. So it will be available for containers by default. And I know RunC, it's Open Containers Initiative, solution from Open Containers Initiative. They are working on live migration implementation. And when it's done, default Docker containers will have live migration as well. So it's coming to everyone very soon. And I hope much more people will be able to benefit from this solution. So on another layer, we have orchestration. Yes, containers orchestration. Because it's not enough just migrate one container. You need to manage multiply containers. And you need to redirect traffic and so on. So there is only one, unfortunately, today who provides the solution. It's unfortunately Triality, but we use this technology from 2011. We realized the power of containers in 2011. Again, we found these guys who created Creo, OpenVZ, and we realized, wow, it's so powerful. And we started to build our solution on top of this platform. And another one, it's a Docker. Docker is working on this, and it's coming soon. And I hope they will be able to implement it as soon as possible. So we will have less work for to do after that. So I would love to show some demo how live migration works with Minecraft. But let me see if I have internet connection and I can show how it works. Okay, so unfortunately, internet is not very good, but yeah. We will distribute this presentation, and there is a video link to the video. We recorded this video during the conference at Microsoft, so you can see, like, so for example how it works. You log in inside Minecraft server, you play, like, and Minecraft server is on Amazon, and you press button, you just migrate to another region and another cloud. I think it's possible. Okay. And couple more minutes about like Jelastic, how to use this live migration. So the main point about our solution, it's a topology wizard. You have different layers like load balancing, application server, databases, and like MTVPs. And you can design your topology very easy. So you need, if you want to choose different containers, certified containers, you can choose it. Different versions, let's say, and you set limit for vertical scaling, how many resources per each container. This one has like about 5 GB of RAM, and if you want a horizontal scaling, it's just one click, and you have now like six containers, load balancer. This one is based on Nginx. If you wish to change, it's possible to do, like to HA proxy, let's say, and they are automatically configured to each other. So you don't need to go to configuration files and tweak it. Like, so it's already done. If you want to change it, it's possible because there is an option to change it. So you can provision your topology on different clouds. Like again, you can choose different clouds here, and at the end, if we talk about live migration, so how it works, I have this Minecraft. Yeah, so Minecraft demo. So this one is on Amazon, and you choose another region. And if you see like green LM title label, so you just press button and confirm. And application will be migrated from one cloud to another one cloud. So pretty easy, like couple of clicks, and you can get very advanced solution. So in other words, Jelastic it's like exoskeleton, like Iron Man. I believe you saw movie, like, so you put this exoskeleton on you. And then you